just got us talking. Yep, he doesn't even know why.
He will soon.
He will soon. Welcome back to the show, everybody. Our next guest grew up a Timberwolves fan and dreamed of playing in the NBA, but he didn't have the height or the talent to make it work. Those are his words, not mine.
Instead, he became a comedian. Please welcome to the show, John Savage. Good morning, John. How are you?
Hey, good morning. Good to be here. Thanks for having me.
John, it has been a pleasure to have you. I heard just a moment ago, because this is something I think a lot of us men can relate to.
Sure.
You wanted to play in the NBA. That is exactly what I wanted to do with my life, and yet I ended up on this couch.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, who didn't growing up watching Kevin Garnett, watching the Wolves, watching the NBA? It seemed like the dream gig, in my opinion. Unfortunately, things didn't work out as planned.
I do want to know, did you want to be KG? Was this the Cassell era, the Sprewell KG era? Because, I mean, that was, I think I wanted to play for the Timberwolves as well during that time.
Yeah, exactly. That was, I mean, I remember, and this is kind of what the show is about. I remember being a kid and begging my parents to let me stay up the extra few minutes to watch the Wolves games, and being in my basement with the Little Tykes basketball hoop and practicing my shooting. So, you know, looking back, I don't think I would have been maybe KG. I would have been maybe like more of a Wally Szczerbiak, posted
nice.
Up in the corner, waiting them to get me the ball so I can shoot it, you know.
Just waiting for the ball.
Hey, no, Wally Szczerbiak was a heck of a player back in his day. That's no doubt a very good choice. And John, the show, it kind of touches on going after your dreams, doesn't it? And like staying true to your dreams and going for it no matter what, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And maybe I should get in a better headspace here so I can talk about it.
Yes. Fantastic.
Yes,
well, you never know if any coaches out there are watching. I always stay ready.
Dream never dies, John.
Exactly. But no, that's exactly right. I mean, on its face, it's really a show about following your dreams and about really going after what you want. But when you dig a little deeper, it's also about navigating those dreams when you maybe grow up a little bit and you become an adult and you realize, hey, maybe this was a little ambitious. Maybe this is out of reach. Maybe there are other things out there that I didn't even know about that, you know, suit my skills and passions better. And how can I navigate and grapple with that? So, you know, it's supposed to be funny. It's supposed to provide some laughter during the winter, but hopefully there's some takeaways for everyone there too. And a lot of great, cute pics of me playing basketball from when I was a kid.
Yes.
Gotta love the throwbacks. Okay, you're being a little humble now, and you're talking about, okay, yeah, I didn't make it in the NBA. You gotta kind of give up on the dream, but you've done some pretty big things. You've been featured in this list I have, The Washington Post, Funny or Die, MTV News, more. Once you figured out that, hey, this path isn't gonna happen for me, but this is the trajectory I wanna go on, you saw a lot of success. I mean, what has that been like for you to see that there was a whole different world out there that you didn't even know existed and that you're actually really good at it?
Yeah, totally. Well, you know, first of all, appreciate the kind words. When I was looking back on it, one of the reasons I might have wanted to play basketball and the reason I gravitated toward team sports like that when I was younger was because I love connection and I love working with people. I love working toward something, working toward a goal. And I kind of realized that is what I can do with comedy and writing. It might look a little different. It might involve less sweating, thankfully, and less physical exercise. But at the end of the day, that's really what I want to do is, you know, create a space where I can make people laugh, make people reflect, where we can all kind of join in something together and have an experience. And, you know, it might not be basketball, but it's certainly a passion of mine now and something that I love doing.
And John, I was told that, you know, you intend to use your Jewish background to kind of provide an atmosphere of anti-Semitism as well and speak on that a little bit. What's that all about?
Yeah, well, a lot of my shows, you know, I obviously, they say to talk about what you know and talk about your personal experiences. And for me, being Jewish is definitely a thread that goes throughout everything I do in my whole life. And so, you know, whether it's intentional or not, it always kind of makes my way into my work. A few years ago, I did a kind of long form show similar to this about my experience with anti-Semitism. And obviously that's something that is still going on. There's a lot of hate out there today. And so I do bring in kind of my personal experiences and help other people understand. And so this show might be a little lighter, but certainly There will be references to my Jewish background in it because I did the research, and less than 1% of NBA players are Jewish. So maybe I can change that.
Yeah, absolutely. Like we said a moment ago, the dream does not die yet, John.
Never.
I mean, you've got a lot of years left in you, and I think this can definitely happen, 100%.
Hey, I do want to ask you one thing before we go. I've heard before that when you get like the joke and people are laughing, it's the best high ever. Not to put you on the spot, but you got a good one for us?
Wow.
This is tough for me. Let's see. Well, one of my go-tos is, did you hear about the fire at the circus?
No.
It was intense.
Ah!
I got it.
It's a laugh track going.
That honestly
expect
took
more
me.
Of that. You get buy tickets and expect more of that at the show. Just
yes.
Great. Great spot on jokes like that.
I don't know if it's because I'm on no sleep, but that did take me a quick second in my brain to get it. I got it. I was too busy dreaming of playing in the NBA too. So I can relate to John.
True story.
John, we thank you so much for joining us this morning. We can't wait to see the show. Best of luck and have a great show when you get out here. We appreciate it.
Thank you. Thanks so much for having me. Appreciate it.
All right. That's John Savick. Catch him January 13th at the Phoenix Theater. For tickets to the show, go to phoenixtheater.org. Find him online, johnsavittwrites.com. We'll be right back.